Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
So today I'm going to be talking to you about the Prophet Muhammad's last sermon. And as some of you may remember, I have done this project like a while back, but that was in the other classroom. So I was thinking that I would do this topic again, but in a lot more detail. So let's begin. Here's Prophet Muhammad's last sermon. Facts about the Prophet Sallallahu Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi was born in Mecca, Saudi Arabia in the year 570. He is role model for the whole of humanity and was an amazing man at all times. He succeeded in all walks of life by not only being a prophet but also a ruler, philosopher, father and husband. He was a man of patience, wisdom, courage and intelligence. He was an inspiration to millions of individuals throughout the world. At age 40, Muhammad's prophetic vision started in the year 610 and proceeded until 632. From the path of ignorance, mankind was led to the straight path and was better than Allah's guidance. When was the sermon delivered? This next. When was the sermon delivered? The sun was delivered in the year 682 on the 9th day of Dhul-Hijjah, the 12th month of the lunar calendar. The year 10 AH was when the sermon was delivered on the farewell pilgrimage to Mecca. It was also called the Islamic Golden Age when many people embraced the religion by accepting the Prophet's message. Next. What was the purpose of the sermon? Next. What was the sermon's purpose? The sermon's purpose was to be a reminder to the followers and an important admonition that confirmed the end of the prophetic vision. What happened after the sermon? After the sermon, a lot of things happened. The Prophet ended his speech by saying, "Let this present convey the message to the absent." After this speech, he looked up and said, "My Lord, have I delivered the message I was charged with and fulfilled my calling?" He asked, "What will you say when you'll be questioned about me?" In one voice, they said, "We bear witness that you have conveyed Allah's message and have done your duty and that you have made goodness for us." The Prophet pointed his finger to heaven and said to the people, "O Allah, be witness," three times. How can we implement the sermon into our lives? Lessons to be learned from the sermon. Beware of shaitan for the safety of religion. Be mindful. Shaitan will always try to make us do the wrong thing. Do not listen to him. Worship Allah. Perform your 5 daily prayers. Fast during Ramadan. Offer zakah and perform hajj. We must always believe in Allah. Praise Allah 5 times every day. Fast during the month of Ramadan. Offer zakah as an act of generosity and perform hajj. Remember, one day you will stand before Allah and answer for your deeds. If you do a bad action, you should ask yourself, how can I improve myself? The lesson from this is that no matter where you are, Allah is always watching you, so you must remember to do the right thing. I leave behind me 2 things, the Quran and the Sunnah. If you follow these things, you'll never go astray. Always use the advice and teachings from the Quran and Sunnah in every aspect of your life to be successful in the world and hereafter. Thank you for listening.
MashaAllah. 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 Allahumma barik. Allahumma.